Hey everyone, how's it going? The idea that content should be as hard as it was when it first came out is a point that I keep seeing brought up, and I hate it so much that I want to talk about it. Do you remember back in the days where you required several parties to take on Zakum in order to get a helmet that was the best in the game? Well, I don't, because I didn't play that game. Do you remember when you had RNG books in order to upgrade your fourth job skills? Well, I don't, because I didn't play that game. Do you remember when Noble Iphias ring was a good ring? Well, I do, because good luck getting Galax on a new character. But jokes aside, what I want to talk about today is the progression of an MMORPG and trivializing old content. It is no surprise that when Zakum came out, it was a several month long journey to get there. The fact that it was the best gear in the game justified the idea that you had to spend months in order to obtain it. Nowadays, you can easily kill Zakum on level 100 and get its iron face as well as the hat that no longer has really any use. Zakum is at this point no more than a mere stepping stone in your progression towards the content that exists nowadays. And here I come to my first point. Zakum iron face accessories are really good. In fact, they are so good that you end up keeping them for the longest of times until you can replace it with GMS exclusive Sweetwater or Lotus and Damien accessories. How good a certain piece of equipment is towards your progression isn't always very indicative of how hard it is to obtain it. Take, for example, the Dominator Pendant. The Dominator Pendant with the Galax changes has become one of the best pendants in the game, and in fact in Korea it is technically best in slot. How hard is it really to obtain a Dominator Pendant though? If you set aside the RNG to get it, the time gain for it, and just look at how hard it is to kill the boss, it is in fact very easy. I would argue even trivial past a certain point. On the subject of Arcarium, take for example Meister rings and earrings. These are also one of the best gears in the game, and you don't even need to kill any boss to do it. You just need to gather and be lucky while gathering. On the same level as Zakum, you have Magnus. Easy and normal Magnus are very easy bosses that you can do pretty much at the moment that you unlock them. They have a chance of dropping a badge, which is the best in slot until you can replace it with a pitched boss accessory. Now, why am I bringing up all of these? Because in the same realm, we also have Chaos Root Abyss. Now, obtaining Chaos Root Abyss gear in regular servers is something quite easy. You just go onto the auction house and the price is fairly low, unless you're looking for something with really good flames. Reboot players, on the other hand, they hold CRA to a very, very high degree. Some of them even actively hoping that the game doesn't get easier in order to provide the same experience killing CRA for the first time than they did when they did it. And here's where my issue starts. I will speak from experience that when I killed CRA for the first time, Hard Lucid and Hard Will were the hardest bosses in the game. And as such, arcane gear was very sparingly seen. Absolab was pretty much the best gear that you would reasonably expect to get, ever. CRA was the milestone immediately before that, and a milestone that you would get in order to be able to obtain Absalab. After obtaining Absalab, there wasn't really much else to look forward to, so it made sense that CRA be slightly difficult in order to encourage you to do the content, because there's nothing really more to do besides that. However, at the point that we are now, with the release of Saren, Black Mage, Varicella, Gloom, Darknell, all of those hard bosses, CRA just pales in comparison to them. CRA is nothing more than a mere stepping stone, the same way that Zakum, Horntail, or Von Leon are. The fact that CRA top and bottom are best in slot forever doesn't take away from the fact that they are mere stepping stones, as I have already mentioned previously. I don't really know where this idea that content can't be trivialized and everything needs to be as hard as it was when I did it 5 years ago stems from, but I see it a lot, especially on Reboot. The game just has so much more content to look forward to now, forcing everyone to do all the progression from the very beginning and see that the end is so far away and unreachable. It's just a detriment to getting new players to join the game. And if your response to any of this is, well, I have had a hard time doing this and so should you, or if you don't like it then just don't play the game, then I'm really sorry, but I don't have anything to say to you. Now I want to segue and take a brief moment to talk about carries. While I don't actively encourage carries, there is a subsect of people that would greatly benefit from it. I had a really interesting conversation with people a couple of weeks ago article in which we came up with this graph that you see before you. Fun is, to me, the most important metric in any video game, and as such, I tried to map out how fun MapleStory is in relation to what level you are and how you progress. A quick rundown and explanation of this chart. Being level 160 is when your killing speed starts to really, really slow down. Mobs start hitting you for a lot more, and you need to pay a lot more attention. When you reach level 200, you get a small boost, you get your 5th job skills, and you might have the fun with them for a while, but then it gets old pretty quick. All the way to level 220, you're still struggling to kill things. Your speed isn't going up, and sometimes you even hit a wall with arcane power. Once you get past that though, you have a lot to look forward to. You start killing CRA, you start killing Absol, and you start getting gear upgrades. Once you're past that though, there's not really much to look forward to. You're just looking forward to doing dailies, grinding a bit, hoping to get some droplets, and the game slows down once again. Time-gated dailies and those not being fun at all is something that I might address in its own video, but for now, I just want to focus on this red line section. If anyone coming new into the game is thinking about quitting when they reach level 160 and they were having a blast before that, I don't see anything wrong with giving the option of a carry to that person. Giving them this extra boost of power might be what pushes them to keep playing and having fun. If CRA gear were at this point trivial, then this problem might not pose itself as often. It's either that or ease the power progression. If that person ends up quitting because they don't like the game, well, they weren't gonna like the game anyway, and you, having provided that, at least gave them more fun while they were here. Having CRA gear does not take away from the achievement of obtaining CRA gear yourself later on. The only thing that changed was the amount of investment that you had to do in order to obtain it. You still had to do all of the boss mechanics that everyone else had to. Of course, here I'm not talking about multiple runs in order to be able to progress your gear past 12 stars. This is just a small boost in order to have the person have fun while grinding, killing things a little bit faster. And I know for certain that people like this exist because I was one of them at a point, and here I am 3 years later. From my experience, having reached level 200, killing mobs at pretty much the same pace as I was before at level 180, mobs being able to hit me from further away than I could hit them and getting pushed around all the time, it made for a very non-fun experience, and I was considering quitting. And keep in mind that CRA wasn't as trivial of a boss as it is today. And having said that, doing CRA on my own with a friend of mine was just as, if not more, rewarding than every single time that I did CRA after that on every other character that I've leveled. As some closing thoughts, I really hope that people understand the idea that MMOs progress over time. The fact that new content gets added and the line gets pushed further and further away makes it so things that come before it need to be easier in order for the general idea of getting to the end take roughly the same time. I hope everyone takes a step back and thinks, would you really start playing a new game if you knew that it took you 5 years to reach where everyone else is at this moment, and they would already be further ahead by the time that you reach those 5 years? And with that being said, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.